now, here's meteorologist Michelle Muscatello with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 Futurecast.
Most of the rain in our area fell while we were sleeping and then lifted up over central and now northern New England as we've headed through the morning and now afternoon hours. Let's go down to live Pinpoint Doppler 12 radar and we'll show you the details here. We still are on occasion finding a shower or two still making it into southern New England, and that's going to be the same trend for this afternoon. So not everyone sees one here through the second half of the day, but the risk will be there in spots. I do want to widen out the view for you. Still seeing quite a bit of rain across southern New Hampshire, parts of northern Massachusetts, and our rain vision here showing Rhode Island with mostly a half an inch to perhaps an inch of rain. But you can see this bullseye here of very heavy downpours over northeastern Massachusetts and southern New Hampshire. And it was right in this area where some spots picked up as much as 2 to even closing in on 6 inches of rain, and that was in about a 7-hour period this morning. So it caused a lot of flooding up there. We're going to dodge the bullet with that one. As far as our top weather headlines go, we are looking at one more unsettled day as far as getting through the daytime today. Autumn's chill will be in place the next few days, followed by a major weekend warm up. We're going to have hints of summer in the air again this weekend. These are the rainfall totals in Rhode Island. So we came in under an inch in Newport and just under an inch in Smithfield, about a half an inch of rain in the last 24 hours in Providence, and only about a quarter of an inch of rain in New Bedford. Temperature-wise, well, with that mixture of clouds, sunshine, and the occasional shower, we're being held right now into the low 60s. Most areas, skies have been brighter as you've traveled further south and east of the Providence area. And we're going to continue with that partly sunny sky, at least for our southern and eastern zones throughout the afternoon hours. Our slow-moving storm system working its way past the Cape and will continue to lift up to the north and east over the next 24 hours. And as it does, it will lose its grip on our weather. Notice, though, that Futurecast, and this is as late as 5 o'clock in the evening, still has the occasional shower pinwheeling through our area. And actually, as late as, say, 10, 11 o'clock tonight, we could still see a shower in our area. Most of it then shifts to the east, so just the Cape here. Continue with that threat of a shower in the late night hours. We should get back to partly sunny skies for your Wednesday, and the winds will be picking up Wednesday, as well as that drier air and cooler air works in. So temperatures today in the lower to mid 60s for afternoon highs, about 64 for downtown Providence, 64 in Barrington, winds out of the northwest at about 5 to 10 miles an hour. South coast for you, the highs at about mid 60s for Charlestown. You've got a mixture of sun and clouds. Still can't rule out a passing shower. At this point, the best chance of seeing one of those showers would be north and west of 295. So from Burrillville through Foster Center, about 65 for the temperature in Johnston. And we're going to find highs this afternoon in the low to mid 60s, New Bedford and Seekonk, Middletown. Spot shower possible. Otherwise, it's partly cloudy and cool. And we'll still keep that risk of a shower for the evening commute about 58 to 62. Shower possible in the early part of the night, but then skies are partly cloudy and those temperatures should fall down to about 50 degrees for a late night low. Down to 67 for your high on Wednesday and cool Thursday, Friday. But check out those temperatures for the weekend, mid and upper 70s. Sunday afternoon, there may be some spots near 80 degrees for a high. So we get through today and then big time changes. We get into dry air for the extended period starting tomorrow.